Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again. And today I'm coming to share with you those two small journals. I told you about those journals in that video with journal for Svetlana. And I'm coming to share with you those journals, and then I will try to quickly show you how you can make those or larger journals. And it's really very easy. I think it's even for beginners, and you don't need too much for making journals like this. So I'm gonna take this first, because this was first I made. I've been inspired by our Czech. I'm not sure if he was only Czech, but he was born in Czechoslovakia, in Czech Republic, while ago, centuries ago. Amazing and very famous painter, Alfons Mucha. His images are amazing, and we are using them in our projects, because he made presentation for advisors, for shops. He made beautiful, posters for theaters, for movies. He made amazing things, so I was totally inspired by his images. It's some kind of those images. And I made this journal. In this journal, you've got loads of space for writing, because it makes that way. You've got space for beautiful image, and still you've got space for writing. I used only envelopes for that basic. And I just add few papers under every single image. I add few papers. It's paper under image, where you can write it down. And when you somehow move image, it's underneath its larger paper for writing down. Here is also tuck spot where you can slide some your note or something. So I'm gonna show you. Every single large page has pocket here, and also pocket from the top, so it can be loaded really well. So here I use this beautiful image. In that pocket on the top, I've got another gorgeous image from Alfons Mucha collection. This one. And I decorate it with this gorgeous hat. On the back side, it's just plain. So it's on that top pocket. And I used those decorative papers. Those are from that Sweet Paris collection. I think I used them in my first that like Midori style journal, very old. And here I've got another image from Alfons Mucha collection. Here in this pocket I've got this gorgeous ephemera. So you can open that image, and you've got writing space here. And when you open that image on the other side, you've got writing space here. And also you've got large pocket here, and large pocket from the top. And there is this gorgeous. It was image for advert, I think, or Four Seasons maybe. And it's decorated with this heart and this beautiful bow. So it's on that pocket, on the top. Oh, go there. No, go there. I'm kind of slow today. I think it's because weather. It's so cold outside. And here I've got this gorgeous lady. I really love all his images, because he had great, great talent for painting. Oh my god, I forgot. See? And sometimes you've got between those envelopes, you've got space. There are just blank pages for writing. So here is really loads of space for writing. Here again, large pocket, and large pocket from the top. And I've got there this gorgeous image. that lady. And here we've got this gorgeous image. It's open like this one. It's also a pocket here. And when you lift it up, you've got writing space here. And here is like belly band. I'm gonna close it like this. Here we've got this gorgeous lady. Also, I forgot, pocket on the top with large tag with that Parisian paper. Come on, go there. Yeah, I have to stand it up, sorry. Here is pocket. Oh, so, two pockets here. Pocket is behind that lady. When you lift up this image, there is space for journaling. Look at her. And this is advert for champagne. Wow, so amazing. And here is another space for journaling. Here I've got place maybe for some notes or for some photo. Pocket here, another pocket, it's from the top with this gorgeous lady. I'm gonna stand it up again. Make sure I place it right. And here we've got those writing pages. And here we've got large pocket, and pocket for on the top with this gorgeous lady. And this heart. And when I turn it, here I've got this gorgeous lady. And when I open it, it's space for journaling. When I flip it down, it's pocket here and space for journaling here. And here we've got pocket on the top with this gorgeous lady. Oh, those two back, they are four seasons. This is autumn. This lady is autumn, and it can be, oh, this one can be open like this. I forgot. And we've got pocket, we've got pocket here and here. Here is this gorgeous Parisian paper, and I really love this one. She's amazing. She's very beautiful. And it's pocket here behind her. When I open it, it's space for writing. And when I open it here, it's space for journaling. And again, it's pocket, large pocket here. And large pocket from the other side. And top-loaded pocket with this tag. I have to stand it up. So it's on the top. When I open it, we've got those journaling pages. We've got pocket from the top with this gorgeous lady. And again, opening tag. I believe all of them can be open. Oh, and I glue it wrong way, that back side. Oh my God. When I turn it here, here is this amazing lady. I've got her on my clocks. This beautiful lady. And again, when is it open? Like this, there is a large space for journaling. It's pocket behind, small pocket behind her. And when you lift it up, you've got this gorgeous image. And again here, space for journaling. And in this page, basic page, it's large pocket on the top with this gorgeous lady. And I decorate it with silver chain with this paper clip, which is holding those pages together. And with this beautiful flower bouquet. Go there. And we've got large pocket here. large pocket here. So it's on that side. I'm gonna close her all together like this. Oops. And here we've got this gorgeous girl. Oh, here. Sorry. And again, we can open it. It's pocket here. Here is writing space. It's large pocket here. Another large pocket here. And pocket on the top. So this type of journal, or this system I used for putting all those envelopes together, it can be used for photo albums. And as you can see, you can load it a lot, and it's very fast, and it's very quick, and it's very easy to put them together. So here we've got another writing space, pocket on the top with this lovely lady. And again, double tap. I totally forgot that those tags are doubled. When I turn it, here is this gorgeous lady. And it can be opened like this. And here, I swap it. I didn't put that lady on that small envelope. On that small envelope, I made belly band. And when it slipped it down, it's pocket here on the bottom. Hope you can see that. On the bottom, it's pocket. And here is writing space. And it's holding together with this paper clip. And it's large pocket here, and pocket on the top with this gorgeous lady. Again, I use that silver chain and just small ball. It's on the top. Then I turn it. Here is this gorgeous lady. And when I flip it up, it's there space for journaling. Here is pocket. When I open it, here is pocket. And here it's writing space. And this is my last page. Is it? Yes, it is. Yes, this is last page. So it's pocket here, pocket here. Here is writing space. And here, it's large tag, double tag, with this gorgeous lady. So, this is one journal I made. And then I was thinking, oh, I'm gonna try it in much more soft colors, in a much more soft design. I'm gonna put it somewhere. I'm not sure where from. It fell down. Maybe from here. To who you hold it. Speedy. Oh, I don't know. I'm gonna place it here for now. Oh, and it's leather cover. And it's holding with those two drops. And it looks like this one. And then I made this very soft one. It's a soft paper cover. And it's holding with this disclosure, and it's open like this, and I use those Parisian photographies, and I really enjoy to make this one because it has those soft colors. So here I made that extendable pocket here, and I used I think this collection, it's Dawcraft Back to Basic or Back to Purple, something like this. And again, same system. When you flip it up, it's space for journaling. Looks like this. And here is beautiful image. When you open that image, there is space for journaling. And it's pocket behind that image. And also, our large pockets here on the top. And here in this one, I've got this vintage tag. I'm gonna slide it back, and when you turn it, here is pocket, and here is another page, here is like tag spot, here it is beautiful with those hot air balloons, We've got pocket behind that image. Also, when we open it, it's writing space. And when we flip it here, it's another writing space here. And space for photos or for some notes. And again, pocket from the top. But I think I didn't load it this one too much. I've been just enjoying those papers. Yeah, two pockets on this side and one pocket from the top. Here is writing space. And again, one pocket from the top, two pockets here. And when I open it, you've got this gorgeous image from Eiffel Tower. Here it's like, is it? Yeah, it's like tuck spot or like pocket. And when I open that page, it's writing space under that beautiful picture. It's pocket behind that beautiful picture. And when you flip it, all that picture with that pocket, you've got another writing space. And again, here we've got that top-loaded pocket, pocket on the side. And when I open it, we've got beautiful picture with, oh my God, Lily Elise. I think her name is Lily Elise. She's amazing, so gorgeous. And it's pocket here behind her. When you flip it up, you've got space for journaling. She's really gorgeous. And when you open it this way, you've got space for journaling. Like this. And also here can be write something. Here is like tuck spot. And again, pocket from the top. Here, pocket from the top. Pocket here, pocket here. Here is just writing space. And again, pocket from the top. Do I have something inside? No. Here is pocket. And here I made like those corsets. That wrapping. And here we've got small tag opening. With few embellishments, and it's in this corset binding, or what is it, corset holder, come on, go there, it looks like this, and here I've got opening like here, here is writing space, and it's pocket, from where, now I'm lost, here is beautiful picture, I think this is from that world exposition picture. When you open it, it's writing space here. And it should be, oh, it's pocket here. From the top. It's from that very small coin envelope. And here we've got pocket. Here. Here. As you can see, that basic is same. And pocket here. Oh, here I forgot to make pockets from that lace, so it's just like embellishment that lace, and here we've got writing spaces. Those soft colors, they are really gorgeous. Pocket, pocket, and pocket from the top. And here you've got beautiful papers with those Renaissance ornaments. Here is like tuck spot. Here is gorgeous Parisian image. When you open it, you've got writing space here. And here we've got pocket on the top. When you flip it over, it's writing space here. And again, we've got large pocket, and also large pocket from the top. And here I made this layout. Here again, tuck spot on this side. And I found, this is photography of same building, like it's here, like from those who are creating, oh my God, designs, yeah, designers, engineers, designers. So I found an image, which was like idea, and then I found same building, I found that photography, so I put them together. Because it looks amazing. So we've got pocket behind that picture. Then that picture can be flipped on the top. Here is writing space. And also it can be open like this, and here is writing space. And again, it has pocket large, large pocket, and large pocket from the top. Writing space here. And pocket here, and here, and pocket from the top. I will don't show you all those pockets because I didn't put there anything now. And it's writing space here. I'm just gonna show you that it's really a huge versatility with this layout of envelopes. Pocket, pocket, and pocket. And here I really like those ladies. I'm using them a lot because really they are gorgeous. Gorgeous ladies. So here I made small layout. It's pocket behind them. When you opening that image, it's writing space there. And when you flip it here, it's writing space there. And here is like small tuck spot. Our pockets from the top. Those side pockets. And another layout. Here I use that lilac colors. And I am now in that lilac mood. I'm creating another journal with lilac colors. It's not finished yet. I will finish that after my holiday. And again, here are all it's same. It's pocket, pocket. And this is like a large, my large few pages. They are made like file folder. Again, opening like this with pockets. So here we've got this small teeny mini file folder with chair, vintage chair. Here we've got another one, teeny mini file folder. And it can be opened like this. Here is pocket as well. And it looks like this from that other side. I'm not sure if I did this one. Yeah, it's like tuck spot. And here it's like large pocket. And I will have to include some ephemeras with this journal. So it will be on my eBay, this one. That next one will be not on my eBay. And here is like pocket behind this one. So those are my two journals. And now I will try to show you how I made it. Like basic, I choose some of large envelopes. It doesn't matter how large you will take. For those, I use this size of envelopes. I think it's called C5. Those. But for those, if you saw video with Svetlana's journal I made for her, I made that from those large envelopes. You need to cut. Here is that open side. You need to put a small piece on this side to make it like sleeve, like this. So I prepared a few of them. Here I used 14 large envelopes. 14 envelopes like my basic. And then I used, I think, 4 envelopes from one side and 4 envelopes from other side. And you had prepared your envelopes. Oops. You will need to fold them. Fold your flap on that other side and fold your envelopes to match those edges together, those ends together, and prepare all you want to use in your journal, all those large ones, same way. Cut that side, that opposite side from the that flap, cut it a little bit, just small piece to make it like that sleeve, and then this fold on this side, and then fold your envelope on half. I'm gonna show you just with few. Bear with me. Bear with me, please. I should prepare this one. Come on. ones. I'm just gonna show you with four. Like this. And like this. So you've got prepared your envelopes, your basic envelopes. Then take double-sided tape. Oops, where is that end? And take first of your envelope. Let me think to make sure that I will don't screw up. Yes. Fold that flap and place your double-sided tape on that other side. You can put one or two, it depends how much you want to glue it down. I think one will be okay. And make it with this way, make all of them, okay? You don't have to put the two strips, I'm just doing it, I'm not sure why I'm doing it that way. Prepare all of them. Okay, you've got prepared those large ones. And now take your envelope, place it like this. Oh, just a minute, I have to think. No, it will be not possible. Okay. Sorry. Place it like this. Okay? Like this. It depends which hand you work. If you are right hand hunter, not hunter. Oh my god. Not hunter. Right hand worker. Place it this way. If you are left hand worker, place it that other way. Take one of your envelope, take that other one and just let me think. And place it here. You've got that flap, so that other one place like this. Open this one. Am I right? I'm not right. Am I right? Just bear with me. Now I am confused. I did it before. I did it a different way. Yes, I'm wrong. I'm wrong. I'm sorry, people. I'm sorry. I'm confusing myself. I'm so sorry. Place this first one like this. It will make much more easy way to put it together. That other one, take some way for your easy way. It's much more easy to do it this way. Place it on the top and then like flip it over so we are on right. Okay, now we've got right way to put our other envelope. Place this flap inside of that second envelope. Place it nice, straight. You can try it if you have nice touch of both envelope. Hold, because here is long, that long flap. Hold it a little bit. Take your knife and take that inside. I think it will be better if you will use only one double-sided strip, because now it's moving. Yeah. Actually, use only one. It's much more easy to use only one. You will have two. You will have to manage two. I was stupid now. Use only one. And glue it inside. If you will have two, you will have to take off two. So it's much more too many work. And it glues glue like this. Flip it. Left it like this. Take another of your envelope. Place it on the top. Same way. Then hold that bottom. It make it much more easy. And just flip it. So you've got your envelope right way. And again, I'm gonna take it off now. That inside one. I've been stupid. Take that just one strip. I think it will be okay. Because it's inside and it will don't move too much. And put this end to your new envelope. Slide it in nicely. Not like me now, okay? Nicely. See, I shouldn't do tutorials how to do it because I'm doing mistakes. Glue it inside. I have to take the second strip. Fold it and you've got the last one. And again, place your envelope to make it even, you know. Place your envelope for your, you know, it's much more easy, you know, that you've got your envelope right way. Flip it over, put it inside. And we are still working just with those large ones, don't worry. We will continue. Make it nice, even. Oh, take off those strips. I should place there only one. Oh, mamma mia, I will take it now and then I will place it inside. Will I? I hope I will. If you will place only one close to that edge and will left that end without that double-sided tape, you can hold that flap inside without struggling and you can glue it easily. Yeah, I did it before just with one strip. I'm not sure why I'm doing it now so strange way. And glue it down. Okay. So it's like our basic. I'm not gonna continue. Make sure that we will go to end. It's like your basic. Now you will need. Come here. Now you will need to take double-sided tape, and I will explain you why. Double-sided tape, but that foam one, that dimensional. And I will explain you why. I use double-sided tape I used in my spine. And I did it because it makes nice space in those large pockets. And as you can see here, we got one pocket. And when we will glue those envelopes on one side and other side, it will make pocket also from the top. But before, oh yeah, you can glue it now and then you can add those small ones. I'm gonna show you how I am doing it. This will be very long and very confusing video. I'm so sorry. Hopefully we will get to the end. You don't have to place there a large piece. It's just small strip to make sure you will have something for your spine to make there space in those envelopes. So go to your first envelope and place on that end that foam tape. You can glue it also bottom of your envelope, but you don't have to right now because then it's easy to go inside with that glue and put there a bit of glue and glue it that way. Where is my knife? Take this off. Hey, come here. Oh, come on. Here. And place that next envelope nicely on on that previous one. Very nicely. And glue it down. And continue same way with all of your envelopes. And if you will make this with this foam tape, it will make also stronger spine. So then you don't have to struggle with, you know, with the dimension of your spine. It will give you actually spine you need, and you don't have to count somehow. It is, how to explain it? In this, I just glued that one end and that other end to my cover here and here, and that middle part, it's not glued together to this spine, because then it's moving better way. It makes here, it makes like spot, and those papers are folding better way on that part. I mean, on the floor, not on the floor. You know, they are. You can open them very easily. If I will glue this one to that spine, those pages will be very hardly open. They will like stuck to the air. So that's why it's good to use that foam double-sided tape, because it gives you dimension in that spine. So you've got there more space for journaling cards, for tags, for all kind of embellishments. It's just much more easy to do it this way. Then extend somehow then your spine, or to count how you can do it. So glue together all your basic those pages, and then you can add. It will give you this. I didn't glue that last one. It will give you that like book, and it depends how many envelopes you will glue down. And they then take your small envelopes and glue them inside. You can glue. I'm gonna show you. I've got those large envelopes, and I've got, because I can't find any small ones, so I took those CD covers. So I'm gonna show you. I wanna have this CD cover like my holder for picture from the top. So I'm gonna place double-sided tape here. Where is my double-sided tape? Oh, here. Or I'm gonna use, right now I think I'm gonna use just glue. If you wanna have your CD cover like this with that window, or envelope like this, that pocket will be, when you open it inside, glue it, put glue on your flap from this side, and glue it inside nicely like this, and you've got your pocket, and you can decorate it. And it's totally up to you where in that book you will place another opening. If you will, again, I'm gonna show it on that CD. If you will wanna have first pocket, you know, you will have pocket, small pocket here, another large pocket right behind, another large pocket here, and large pocket here. So glue that CD cover this way. Put glue from this side and slide it like this. So you've got pocket here, not pocket when you open it on the top. I hope you understand what I mean. And now I'm going to show you same way. It's with those large ones on the side. I want to have pocket when I open it like this. Here I want to have pocket, not here. So I'm going to glue this envelope inside. Side from this side, just slide it nicely, and I think for this gluing of envelopes, maybe it's better liquid glue not double-sided tapes, because you've got there that timing for managing your envelopes. So I'm going to show you if I will wanna have here envelope, not when I open it, but right here. I'm gonna glue it. I'm gonna put my glue here. And I'm gonna glue it this way. And same is with that CD cover. And as I said, it's better if you will use some liquid glue for this part, because you've got there that time to place your envelopes. So now I've got pocket here. Here I can somehow decorate it. Some picture will be pocket right behind, and another large pocket and large pocket. You know, and when I will open it, I've got here beautiful place space for writing. Yeah. So this is way I made it. And then, as I show you, if you saw that video for Svetlana, I made there from same system. I made for her that holder for goodies. And it was just, I made same basic. Then on that end, I glued different type of envelope. I don't have white envelope, same type, but I've got this one. So here on the end, I glued this type of envelope. I glued it here. And then I used that, this large envelope, I used like my closure, because I just fold it over here. So it was from the back side to here. Here I made closure, and when she opened it, she got here cover, and then she had those pockets filled with goodies. See, you've got two pockets here, you've got also pockets here. It depends how you put your envelopes. So this way I made that holder or loaded pocket for Svetlana. From same basic, just other way to place down. So this is my sharing for today. Hopefully it will give you some idea. Hopefully I hope I was in view. Oh my god, I didn't check it. So this is my sharing for today. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for your support. You are amazing, amazing. Thank you so much. I love every single one of you. You are my huge inspiration. Right now, I stuck on on one channel. Oh my god. Crafty King. I don't know which name she has, because I know Paper Phenomenal. Or Crafty King. Katy Orta King. I just have in my head that Paper Phenomenal, because she is. Oh my god, that girl has amazing ideas. I'm making my travel journal from her ideas. I totally love her work. Oh my god, she's amazing. Her work is stunning. It's phenomenal. Really. So I stuck on her channel right now. I think I'm watching her 100 video. Because those ideas are wonderful. Really wonderful. So thank you so much for all your inspiration, ladies. Thank you so much for brilliant tutorials. If you are a beginner, I highly recommend Paper Crafter 45. She has a huge talent. She's got amazing ideas. So go there, pop up there, Paper Crafter 45. This lady, Katy Orta King, I think, or Paper Phenomenal. I think it's Katy Orta King YouTube channel and Paper Phenomenal her blog. Or maybe I messed up. I will put links for those two down below. There is a million amazing artists, crafters more. So go to check out all of them if you have a time. Thank you so much for watching, for your comments, to be here, to watch me. Hopefully you'll find some inspiration. And see you next time. Thank you so much. Bye. Take care, people. Take care. Bye.